Hello everybody. This video is about polynomial regression with scikit in Jupyter Notebook. So you have the data set, and as usual you need to load it. So loading the data set. And to load the data set, we need to import pandas library. So we have import pandas as pd. Run it. Then we read the data. I call the object my data equal pd dot read underscore csv parentheses code, and the data is found in this folder. This is the dataset discharge, so let me copy the directory. Excuse me. And paste it here. Double the backslash and the write discharge here. Dot CSV. Slashes, we need to double them. Okay, so we run, then we try to see the content of the data, the description. So my data dot describe, so this is what we have in the discharge data set. Have t as time, sm as soil moisture, sc as soil temperature, at as air temperature, et as evapotranspiration, sh as specific humidity, p as precipitation, and we have d, this is the river discharge. BG is the location, the station where the discharge data was recorded or registered. Okay. This is another location, LG, where the river discharge was recorded also. So you have this column for river discharge at location A. Location BG, and the last column is the river discharge at location LG. So let's see the correlation between the features. Okay. We have soil moisture and discharge at location BG. And we see the correlation equal 0.81. Although the correlation doesn't mean causation, I am going to take the soil moisture as the input feature and the river discharge at BG as the output feature. So our output or dependent variable or response variable is discharge BG for this analysis, and our independent variable or input feature or predictor or regressor is the soil moisture. So let's go to the next step, which is preparing the input and the output data. input and output features. For this we need to import the variable NumPy, the library NumPy, sorry. So import NumPy as np. Okay. Now we are going to deal with the input variable. The input variable or input feature call again independent variable, call also regressor, also call predictor. Okay, x, let's call it x, equal, it's going to be a 2D array, yes, equal np dot array, my data, brackets, SM. And to make it a 2D array, we need to use the function reshape with the argument -1, 1. So this argument -1, 1 gives us a 2D array. So we have to run it. Okay, now we type x dot shape to see. So it tells us that we have 84 rows in one column. The column for soil moisture, 84 observations. Okay, now we go for the output variable. Which is the dependent variable, call also response variable. So y equal np dot array, my data colon brackets, as I said, is discharge at BG. So here, if you type y.shape, this is what you get. So the next step is to transform the input feature to include the polynomials. So the polynomials, we say squared, cubic, should be square instead of square. So those are the polynomials. So cubic or more terms as additional features. When implementing polynomial regression, and for this we need the class need to use the class polynomial features. So we are going to import this class from sklearn.create processing. Import polynomial features. Okay. So the next step is to create a variable we can call transformer to transform our input feature. So let's create this variable called transformer equal polynomial features. We set the degree here. I go up to 6 degrees. So, and include bias equal false, we set to false because we don't want to have the intercept here. And we run it, so we have a transformer now. Okay, let me write comment here. This variable, the variable transformer to transform the input feature. So the next step is going to fit the transformer. Fitting the transformer. To fit the transformer, we are going to take our transformer, which is here, polynomial feature, and fit it with x. Transformer.fit. X. And we run it. Okay. And let's go to the next step. Now we need to create the new or a new modified input variable or feature we can call x underscore. So here we have x underscore equal transformer dot transform x. So x underscore is the result of transforming x. Transformer is not okay. I need R here. As transformer dot fit. Okay. And we run it. That's okay now. So let's print our new input feature and see what it looks like. Okay. Next step is to create and fit the model itself. Creating and fitting the polynomial model. Sorry. To do this, we need to import the linear regression class. So it's going to be from sklearn. Linear model import linear regression. Invalid syntax. So there is a problem. From sklearn dot linear model. From sklearn dot linear model import linear regression. Oh, sorry. From here instead of from sklearn instead of import twice. So from sklearn. Okay, it's fine now. Sorry about that. So the second step is to have the model itself. For the model, let me call it model equal linear regression parenthesis dot fit. We're going to fit it using our modified version of x and y. But remember again, here I skipped the step which is to divide or to split the input and output features into for the train and the test data. I didn't know that, but normally you need to do that. And fit on the train and test on the validate on the test data. So this step I skip it. So this is our model. Now we need to output the results. Getting the model results. What do we need first? The intercept. Model intercept, we need to print. The intercept is column, comma, here my model dot intercept. So the intercept negative here, minus 13,377, about 0.30. Okay, so this is the value of the river discharge when there is no soil moisture. No input, no X, no input feature. So the next thing we need is the slopes of coefficients. Meaning you have the beta 1 to beta 6. Here the intercept is beta 0, the bias. So we are going to print now the beta 1 to 6. Print the model. Okay, so the first is beta 1, so the intercept is beta 0 here, and you have beta 1, soil moisture, beta 2, soil moisture square, beta 3, that's the cubic soil moisture, and beta 4, soil moisture to the power 4, beta 5 here, soil moisture to the power 5, beta 6 and soil moisture to the power 6. So our y, which is the model formula y, if you want to derive the model formula from these equations, you would have y equal minus 13,377.27 plus 1.27 10 to the power minus 8 times soil moisture plus 6 point about 26 times 10 to the power minus 6 soil moisture square plus 1.44 positive 1.44 times 10 to the power minus 3, 1, 2, 3, so it's going to be soil moisture to the power 3, minus 5.60, 10 to the power minus 6, soil moisture to the power 4, plus 7.70, times 10 to the power 9, 10 to the power minus 9, sorry. Soil moisture to the power 5 minus 3.63 10 to the power of minus 12 times soil moisture to the power 6. So we have the model formula from these equations. Okay, so the next step is having the, let's say, the coefficient of determination. Which is the R square. Okay, we have R square equal my model dot score x our modified input feature and our output feature. And we print the squared is come on here RSQ. Okay, this is, it means that the model is spent about 70% 71% of the variation of the river discharge. So now we are going to make the prediction. So let's call the object wipeout equal my model dot predict at underscore as modified. Okay, this underscore instead of plus. Sorry about that. So now we are going to print the predicted values. River discharge dot dg. So print the predicted river discharge, predicted values of river discharge. After the course is wipe right, comma, open the course, but slash and this to have our values. Okay, so this is what you have. Wipe right. Now we are going to find the coefficient of determination of the prediction. And the R square, that's R between Y pred and Y. R squared. To do this, we need to import from sklearn.matrix, import the R2 score. Now have our object R square equal R2 underscore score Y underscore pred Y. This is our R square. Now we are going to print this R square. Yes, R square is so the R square is the R square between the predicted and the observed with the discharge. This is what it means. This that and so as Q. So 0.59. So 59% for the variation is spent. So the difference is about let's say 59, and we have a square here about 71. Okay, 11% difference. Let's say 71, 59. Okay, round it 12%. But we round here at 60, and here at 70 is 10%. Well, okay, here 70.93, so we round it to 70, 71, and here we round it to 59. Okay, so 12% difference. Okay. So we go to model evaluation. For the model evaluation, we need to import the matrix class. So from sklearn, import matrix. Okay, and then we go ahead and have our mean squared error. Let me see. We are going to print it. Print. The MSC is come here matrix dot min underscore square underscore error y plate y. So this is the mean square error. If we need the root mean square error, we are going to take the square root of this and put with np. Have an array. So the root mean square error rmsc. Print. The RMSC is np dot the square root of the mean square error. Have y prime and y. We run it. It's the value. If you need the mean absolute error, we have MAP. We print it. The MAE is one after the quotes matrix dot mean absolute error y right y. We run it. Okay, so now we are going to plot the observed against the predicted against the observed over the charge. to do this, there are libraries and classes we need to import. Okay, we need to import matplot, lib.pyplot as plt. We also need to import the linear model from the scalar. Linear_model. To have our line of regression. And then finally, we need to import the cross-val predict. From sklearn.model selection import cross_val_predict. So these are all necessary for our plot. So now let's go to the plotting itself. So we need to have an idea about the type of plot we need. I mean, set the size. Figure AX equal subplot. PLT.subplot, sorry. Okay, this is what we have, the subplot. So we are going to feed it or fill in it with the next step is going to, we need the scatter plot. So we have AX dot scatter. We have y is on x-axis and the y-pred is on y-axis, xy. Okay, that's the second line. These are the scatter plot. First line, let's say type, the subplot we need. Like the type, okay, the type specifically we need the scatter plot. Okay, so the next step is going to define the min and the max values. Mainly it's like the boundary, you need to set the boundary using the min values and the max values of y, sorry. So ax.plot parentheses, so we have a bracket. So we are going to start with y dot min. Okay. And end with y dot max. And then we do the same thing for x and y. Y dot min. Y dot max. Okay. Kind of boundaries set. So we need the type of line for the line of best fit. We are going to have the dashes and the line width, let's say 4. Okay, we run it. Okay, so the first line gives us the type of what we need, the subplot. The second line gives us the scatter plot of the data points, y pad. And the third line of plots, you see here, it goes from 0 to 2000, 0 to 2000. So these are the y min and y max on both axes. This is for x axis. This is for y axis. And this type of line we need the dash here. And the LW equal 4, this is the width of this. Okay? So now we are going to create the labels. Labeling. So we start with our x label, so ax dot set x label. So x label is observe river discharge. And the unit is cubic meter per second. Okay, so this is what you have here below, river discharge cubic meter per second. Okay, we need to put on space between okay, I missed R here and space here, okay. So that's it. Okay, now it's okay, observe river discharge cubic meter per second. So we do the same thing for the y axis. Y-axis ax dot set underscore way y label predicted river discharge. And also cubic meter per second. Okay. But we still have a line here as well. You see, text 0.5 predicted river discharge. So the last line is going to be plot plt.show. Plt.show. Parenthesis. If we run this, this text is going to disappear. This first. Going to show only the plot. Okay, so this is what we have. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it's going to help you to perform your polynomial regression. But remember, I told you before that you need to split the data into train and the test data set. I didn't do it. But yeah, you need to do that when you get specifically at this level. Yep. After you have your transformer, the modified input variable feature, you need to split your y and x, your new x into training and the testing data set, and continue your work. So thank you for watching this video. Once again, I wish you to get something helpful from it.